They did it with Joe Jackson, Michael Jackson's father. You know, their success is single-handedly because of Joe Jackson. But they were able to convince the kids to leave your father. Nobody want to do the work. They don't want to see the process. They just want to get there when it's the success.
Yeah, definitely.
They tried to get Venus and Serena to leave their father, but they wasn't having it. They tried to get between Tiger Woods and his dad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because when I interviewed Danny, he definitely kept it real. He definitely said what the media had been saying for years about Maurice is not true. And then after doing the interview with him, I definitely have a newfound respect for new kids.
Right. Because let me tell you something. People don't know Maurice is a good guy, all right? There were times when, you know, I couldn't pay my bills, and I called Maurice, and whatever I needed from him, Maurice would do. Anyone that know Maurice, man, you have not found, could not find somebody with a kinder heart. And I'm going to tell you, I grew up around drug dealers, around killers, around some of the worst people you want to be around. And it's amazing. Some of them have good hearts, too. Maurice have a good, genuine heart to help someone. He didn't know me. He didn't have to do what he did for me. But he did it. And he never asked for nothing in return. So for someone to try to, you know, dehumanize someone and put on, see, when a person can't get to you, they try to assassinate your character. And the thing is, when they try to assassinate your character, based upon what? It's almost like what's happening in the media right now with Barack Obama. Here it is, here's this guy. They can't get to him because it seems like he just lived a righteous life. So they got to assassinate his character by the people that are around him.
Mm-hmm.
So you get people, and it's so sad because living in New York City, when the World Trade Center was hit by those planes, let me tell you, I've seen people jumping from the buildings to their death. I can't tell you whether they were independent, whether they were Republicans, or whether they were Democrats. I didn't look at whether they were black, whether they were white, whether they were Indian, or whether they were Japanese. What I looked at was there were people that was on American soil that was throwing their lives off this building, hoping that somehow or the other that they'll land and they'll be safe. And unfortunately, that's not what happened. So when people understand that when we were under attack, for them to start looking at now, oh, this person is to the left, this person is to the right, it's so sad that this is a Christian nation, but yet while we're a Christian nation, we don't even look at the role that God is trying to play in the whole situation. The number 40 from the Bible to now represents a significant change. The people that God told Moses to go to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let his people go, the journey was supposed to take 11 days, but took 40 years because the people were hard-headed and they wouldn't listen. So now, 40 years ago, you had King saying that he had a dream that this nation will one day rise up and things will change. Now, how ironic would it be when King is really talking about black and white? So now you have a black man from Kenya, Africa, that impregnates a woman from Kansas. They have a son, and his name is Barack Obama. Then the young man spends time in the Middle East growing up. Now, if there's anyone 40 years to the year that's on the scene, that's talking about healing America and bringing everybody together, this is the man on the scene. So with all that's been done in the media, everyone that from Jeremiah Wright to this to that, they keep wondering, why is this guy still ahead? Why is he still winning? And look at his spirit. Through all that was thrown at him, he always rose above it.
He basically took it in stride with his head high and just like, yo, keep bringing your best shot.
You know, the thing that's so funny that blows my mind is for them to say that he's an elitist, right? The two people that said he's an elitist is Kane said, this guy. McCain said he's an elitist. Meanwhile, McCain has been rich forever. His wife last year made $100 million just last year. Bill Clinton made $100 million. Barack Obama just paid up his student loans from the money he got from writing a book. But he's an elitist. He tell you that he was on welfare, but he's an elitist. He told you he grew up in a single-parent home, but he's an elitist. Let me tell you something. When you grew up in a single-parent home and you was on public assistance, you don't walk around with your head in the air like you're better than anybody, because if that's the case, you would never tell someone how far down you were. If if you're going to tell someone how far down you were in life, you're not telling them that because you think you're better than them. You're telling them that because you're letting them know no matter where you start at, you can do better with your life if you choose to.
Mm-hmm. Right. Now, going back to the Barrio Boys and the How We Roll album, when I first got it, I was like, slept on group, slept on album. Why didn't they blow up more?
Well, the reason why the group didn't blow up more, unfortunately, the same sickness that happened to so many groups had happened to the Barrio Boys. The people start getting in their ear, starting with Abraham Quintanilla, which is Selena's father, for those that don't know. Well, we had a good relationship with Selena. She did a song with us called Don't They Get Us as Deaths, which was 6 weeks at number one. And Abraham started by trying to get the group to leave me. And one of the guys that was in a group that always wanted to be a solo artist. And when you put together a group, you got to be very mindful that not to put someone in a group that want to be a solo artist. Some people want to be a solo artist before their time. You know, Boyz II Men initially had five members in the group. And one of the guys in the group wanted to do a solo project. So when he left Boyz II Men, the other four stayed together and they ended up with the deal. And guess what? The other guy that wanted to be a solo artist never surfaced.
Right.
So the same thing with the Barrio Boys. Freddie Correa wanted to be a solo artist. So he kept carrying on. I had to remove him out of the group. I replaced him with Hans Fidalgo, which is singing the majority of How We Roll. And sometimes you want to hold on to somebody, and God has something better for you. You just got to let it go and move on.
Mm.
So I let him go, and I put Hans in the group. And then later on, Abraham was still trying to get the group. Even after his daughter died at the funeral, he was still trying to convince the group to leave me and go with him. Can you believe that?
Yeah, that's nuts, man.
It's nuts, but it's the truth, man. And my whole thing is being honest and forthright. And the group continued to listen to other people and allow people to get in their ear and turn them against me. And they thought that they could just, you know, do it without me. And for the time that they departed from me, you know, first Freddie left, and then Angel, and then Robert Vargas, and then I had Dave and Hans, and I just rebuilt the whole group. And I put Jeff in there, I put this guy Jimmy, and I put this guy named Rob McLeod in there. And we did another album called Destiny. And then that group broke up, and then Hans and Dave flipped out. They went with the old group members, and they went to this investor that I got to put up money for the group, and they figured they was going to do it and not have me involved. And they changed the name to Boyz Del Barrio. And the thing is, you don't change the name that you built up over 10 years. Anyone, that's like business 101. Your brand, your name is what's worth it. Could you imagine Coca-Cola saying they're going to change their name? It's like everyone knows about Coca-Cola. Why would you change the name? Mm-hmm. Well, we don't want to pay the person that owned the name any money. Well, pay him, use the name, and make money.
Right.
You know, he's so busy trying to injure the other person, you indirectly injured yourself. So nothing happened with their album.